Nothing is scheduled for a one ball. Biggie is weathering being accompanied by the ninth wonder of the world, China, from Greenwich, Connecticut, weighing in at 250 pounds, Triple H.
As we get set for perhaps the greatest tag team match in the history of the WWF, where is Shane McMahon?
Well, that's a very good question. His buddies are here, but we don't see the head honcho. But we are going to see four of the most diverse personalities ever to engage in a tag team match right here tonight, Michael. But will it turn into every man for himself? Or is it some kind of plot or set up or trap? These guys just cannot get along.
Tag team partner, being accompanied by Paul Bearer, he weighs in at 326 pounds.
Our question has been answered.
The Undertaker.
I never thought I would see Shane McMahon and The Undertaker shoulder to shoulder in a family gym. We have seen the forming of an unholy alliance right here tonight on SmackDown.
And they are in cahoots, and The Undertaker, who organized the Ministry of Darkness, who terrorized Vince McMahon's family and attempted to control the WWF by extortion, has now joined forces with Shane's corporation to form the corporate ministry.
Shane McMahon has deemed it such, the corporate ministry. The Undertaker and Shane McMahon, the son of Vince McMahon, who's run this company for two decades. And what have we seen formed here?
You smell what The Rock is cooking?
From Miami, Florida, weighing in at 275 pounds, The Rock!
The Rock, former WWF champion, who was kicked out of the corporation this past Monday night on Raw because Shane McMahon said The Rock failed him in his battle against Austin at Backlash this past Monday night.
Well, let's not forget, he was kicked out of the corporation after he basically called Shane McMahon name in the book. It was a pretty good bet. He was fixed to quit.
The Undertaker and Triple H, apparently their only bond, their only link, being Shane McMahon.
They're cornering The Rock, and he slips out from the middle of them.
And The Rock now hammering away on Triple H, and right now, folks, we've got a 2-on-1. The Rock's partner, Stone Cold Steve Austin, but the rattlesnake is nowhere to be found. Inside, and Austin going for the Phenom. And a Phenom with a right hand to Stone Cold Steve Austin. And another one for the 7-footer. The Undertaker is evil. He's a changed man. He's demonic. And tonight he's formed an allegiance with Shane McMahon, the corporate ministry. And here's Austin. Loose that press. And Austin heading away on The Undertaker.
And look at him on The Undertaker. Austin, it turns. Trying to be a sadistic to The Undertaker as The Undertaker was sadistic. Austin.
Cover now. And Triple H makes the save after two.
Boy, I'll tell you what, we have got mayhem, and if you look outside the ring, we've got enough supporting cast of characters to have a full-scale street riot.
But Jim, if Stone Cold and The Rock can work together, they may be the only two guys in the WWF who could pull it off going through this corporate ministry.
Good Lord, Austin sagged in the corner, and he comes right back out fighting this. There is no quitting the rattlesnake. And I doubt very seriously if you will see Stone Cold Steve Austin tag The Rock into this match.
Stone Cold now kicked to the midsection, went for the stunner, Triple H countered, he caught him with a knee to the face. Triple H and The Undertaker on one side, Austin and The Rock on the other. You see Shane McMahon, China, the Mean Street Posse outside the ring, cheering on Triple H, who missed with the knee.
You never thought it would be possible. I don't even know if Vince McMahon himself could have made this merger come about.
What can Vince McMahon and Stephanie McMahon can't be thinking, and Triple H now goes for the cover, and Austin gets the shoulder up.
Do you suppose they're at home now? Do you suppose that they know anything about this? Do you suppose that they can grasp that Vince's son, that Stephanie's brother, could do something like this and stab the whole family in the back?
For weeks, The Undertaker playing mind games, psychological warfare on Vince McMahon and Stephanie. And tonight, an allegiance apparently has been formed with Vince McMahon's son, his only son, the heir apparent to the throne, Shane McMahon.
And in this case, Michael, I would have to say that the sins of the son will be paid back by the father somehow. Vince McMahon has never stood for something like this to go on.
His capacity crowd comes to life. Stone Cold now, hammering back on Triple H, off the second rope. Austin now, the rattlesnake on the attack. And he caught him. Sledgehammer to the face. And here comes The Rock. And so far, Austin and The Rock working as a unit. A hard tag from the People's Champ.
Can you believe they made that tag? Anybody who's seen Austin and Rock's wars at WrestleMania and Backlash knows they got no love for each other. The only thing they have in common is a dislike for Shane McMahon.
Austin and Rock didn't want to be partners. They were forced to this one by Shane McMahon. And now Rock, the three-generation athlete in the WWF, hammering away on the Phenom.
Well, I'll tell you, while Rock's a college man through and through, Austin is redneck as redneck can be, and they do make an unlikely pair.
Cover by the Phenom now. There's two, and Rock gets his left shoulder up.
They didn't choose this situation, Michael. Let's make that clear to everybody. Stone Cold nor The Rock chose this. They were forced together by Shane McMahon as a slap in the face, as an embarrassment.
The Undertaker and Triple H not forced together. They're part of this whole corporate merger. The corporate team of the ministry, and The Rock planted The Undertaker. Hook of the leg now. There's one, two, and again. Triple H makes the save.
How long do you think this has gone on? How long do you think that Shane McMahon and The Undertaker have been on speaking terms, much less in cahoots?
Shane McMahon cheering on The Undertaker, and here comes the Brahma Bull, the 275-pounder, whipped into the ropes now. Undertaker misses with a clothesline, and both men knock each other down.
The Rock, charismatic, electrifying, we've said it, a three-time WWF champion, unprecedented for a man of his age. His best years are still ahead of him, and the ones he's had are pretty darn good.
And don't forget The Undertaker, one of the most spectacular athletes, the Phenom, in the history of the WWF, from the dark side, who's made a demonic turn. And listen to the crowd.
Can you believe it? They are so firmly behind The Rock.
Rock now whipped into the corner by the Phenom. Undertaker misses. Rock counters. Rock bottom. Triple H. And here's Austin now. Austin with right hand to Triple H. And all four men going at it.
Well, that's all it took to light this one on fire. This is like walking through hell.
Wait a minute. Wait a minute. Here comes the rest of the corporate ministry. Boss Man, Acolyte, Viscera, Midian. Big Show, Tess Shamrock, and clear the ring of the corporate ministry.
Folks, I'll tell you what, the corporate ministry's not the only one that's got some backup. The Big Show, Stone Cold, The Rock, Tess, they're all standing tall.
Look out now, Austin and Undertaker in the ring. Undertaker with a boot to the face. Keep in mind, folks, the referee has called for the bell.
This thing is spread all over the building. They're fighting the crowd. They're fighting on the stage. And there's Shane McMahon with that metal folding chair.
Wait a minute, Austin in trouble. What a counter by Austin! Undertaker! Oh no, Austin! Could be planted here with a choke slam! Choke slam! The Rock and Triple H have battled through the crowd! Wait a minute! Set him in the chair! Vince McMahon's here! Vince McMahon! Just cold-cocked his son Shane!
Vince McMahon just knocked out his own son!
The Undertaker with a chair! Vince McMahon has grabbed the chair! Vince is standing with Austin! Oh! Vince McMahon has sacrificed himself for Austin! Returning Austin's favor from Raw!
My God! My God, that's the ultimate sacrifice!